You all are going to start noticing something happening on YouTube, starting, well, today, where a lot of thumbnails are going to be changing, and you might think, wait, these creators are just changing thumbnails, maybe they're doing it to trick people into rewatching a video, I've seen that talked about in the past, but actually it's because of a new feature that creators have, and I thought I'd give you a peek behind the curtain of how it works, and it lets you basically compare the performance of different thumbnails. The feature is called Test and Compare, and as you can see, this is what a result example looks like, but I'll show you what it looks like to actually like start a test and stuff. And it basically shows you just which thumbnail does the best. It's actually been in like a testing phase for a long time, but just today they announced that they are rolling it out to everyone. Most creators that have access to the advanced features will be able to do this now, which I think you just need to like verify your phone number. So you might see thumbnails changing on videos that maybe are in your watch later list or just show up in your feed, and this is why. So why don't I show you what it looks like to actually go and create one of these tests, and then I can show you a bunch of examples if you're interested from some tests I've done on the past videos I've made, and you can kind of see, you know, which ones I put out there to test and which ones ended up being the result. So to create one of these tests, it would show up in the edit video section, and you could see on the thumbnail button, you click the little three dots, and then there's an option to test and compare, and then this window comes up and you have an option to upload three files, up to three files, but it can be just two. This little info icon shows you a little bit more info. Anyway, what you do is after you add the different versions, you click to start the test, and then while that's going, it'll say that a test is currently running. And you'll also notice that the thumbnail kind of shows as like a double split thumbnail between the two versions. If there's three, it would be split three ways, I guess, to kind of signify that there's a test going on. And you'll notice it says the estimated time is up to 2 weeks. I have never seen it take that long, I don't think. I think it, again, depends on how many views it's getting. If it is like a video I just uploaded, usually like within a few hours, it will show a final result. But in the meantime, it'll actually show you results before the test is even done, so you can start to kind of get an idea. And once it is finished, it shows this little messaging and icon saying that the test completed. And of course, it automatically uses the best performing thumbnail as the permanent thumbnail. And you can also run a different test. You can like stop the test and run a separate one if you want. And you'll notice how also it uses the watch time percentage as opposed to just like the click-through rate. And I believe that's because, one, YouTube looks at watch time as like the ultimate indicator. If people click into a video at a high rate, but then they immediately click away, they don't think that's a good video, the algorithm. So it's kind of the same thing here. You might have a thumbnail that is really clickbait and gets people to click on it, but then if it's not what they were expecting in the actual video, that might actually make them watch less. Though I'm sure it still kind of takes the click rate into account partially, because obviously if a thumbnail, if no one clicks on it at all, then it's not going to have a lot of watch time anyway. So it's kind of like a combination, I think, all factored in. So just for fun, let's take a look at some of the results for tests I did on some of my past videos. This first one was my ultimate Windows troubleshooter. And you can see this first one, it was kind of like a screenshot of the ChatGPT helper thing. And it's kind of hard to see, I think. So that's probably why the second one did significantly better at like 53.3% versus 46.1%. And you can see again here how the winner says now visible to all viewers. Anyway, moving on, this was the result from my video where I talked about GitHub URLs being used for malicious purposes. This one was really close, and it actually says here that it was limited confidence, like it basically probably didn't matter. And I've actually noticed this where sometimes I'll put two different versions and it doesn't really make as much of a difference as I would have thought and you might have thought. So a lot of times the title is more important, or just kind of the general concept, I think, of the thumbnail is more important. And that's pretty evident here and in other cases that you'll see. This next result was for the video that I talked about, that logo fail vulnerability where like a BIOS could be infected with an image file. And this one actually, even though it kind of is sort of similar, there is a clear winner here. This one got 36%. So that's kind of interesting. I didn't even know really which one would perform the best. So that's why it's nice to have this feature. This was the one I made about that LeBron James meme tweet and how a bunch of people realized that they didn't have their refresh rate set properly on their monitor. And this one was pretty close, even though they're pretty different thumbnails actually for the most part. Though I guess this one kind of makes more sense in the context of the video, 60 hertz, 144 hertz, that's kind of what the video is about, so maybe it makes sense. This next one, I was talking about cool different portable apps for Windows, and I guess these are relatively similar if you kind of squint and look at them, they're pretty similar, and therefore they're not really all that different. This next one also was a big difference. It was where it was like a bunch of general computer tips, and the thumbnail was for like the first tip I give, which is like, you know, putting an exclamation mark to make file names show up first. Anyway, this one got like 36% versus 31 and 32%. Next, this one was a video about command line programs. And again, you can see here how it wasn't too much of a huge difference. And even though I used different text and slightly different images, like I added cool to that one, didn't really make too big of a difference. I think the title pretty much explained what the video was about at that one. So really just seeing the command line image in general and then seeing the title got the idea across. However, this next one actually is a bit surprising to me, and it was where I was talking about cool Chrome flags, and you can actually see that this one was significantly better, and it was really just a change in the text and the red arrow. So usually you think the red arrow is clickbait, you know, it's gonna get more views. Apparently not. In this case, actually the one without the red arrow, and it just said cool Chrome flags, simpler is better apparently. The more clickbait one, where it's like, change these flags, not as good. Here's another good example where I tried a few different versions, one slightly more clickbait than the other. This one, you're missing out, actually did the worst. I actually think that's a pretty funny image. But anyway, it probably came across as too corny, like I get it. The 97% don't get it. Yeah, that's a bit clickbait, but I think it actually better represents what the video is about. The video was literally about how people are saying ChatGPT is not useful, and it's because they haven't really thought of a lot of use cases that I explained. That was the whole point of it. So the first one that is 32%, I was trying out like a vague one, maybe like the vagueness might be intriguing, or just says yes, but turns out no. Here's another example on a video that did really well in general, actually. It was about this like audio tester thing that I just thought looked cool, and so I bought it. But you can see I just tried slight variations, like zoomed in more, with some text and without it, and really it was kind of all identical, like it really didn't matter. So slight variations really don't matter. However, finally, here's one where I talked about that 3D objects folder, and turns out the one with the text that says no one used it is better than the one with text significantly. The one that had the two icons with no description. And again, you might think, oh, well then no one knows what the video is about. You still see the title, so you kind of have to balance that with it. But I do know that a lot of times, myself included, sometimes I'll just look the thumbnail before I ever read the title. And I think in this case, the few words of text simply adds more interest and actually is relevant to the video, so it makes a difference. So yeah, if you do start seeing thumbnails on videos that you put in a playlist or thought you watched already, but it's a new thumbnail, that's why. It's not like anyone's trying to trick you into watching it again. It's simply because of this new feature. Anyway, let me know what you think down in the comments. Did you see this happening already before and you were wondering what that was all about? And you're gonna be seeing it a lot more, I guess. And maybe hate the feature, maybe love it. I don't know, we could talk about that down there. If you wanna keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is the one where I did talk about that useless 3D objects folder in Windows and whatever happened to it. I'll put that link right there and click on. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.